Putting you behind the wheel. HiQ sponsors the BTCC.
British touring cars are back after a six-week summer break, so it's time to swap the swimsuit for the race suit and get back on the pedal.
Reigning champion Fabrizio Giovanardi leads the championship, but with half a season still to go, it's all to play for. And here's a reminder of how the top men have fared so far.
This could end in tears.
Oh. It's not turning into a good day for Tom Chilton.
He's on the podium.
Oh, John's down the inside. He's done it.
To be in this situation is just a dream come true.
Oh, and then they think it's each other.
It's going to be another diesel victory.
It goes to Darren Turner.
Oh, Jackson is Turner.
Great victory by Shedden.
It's Shedden who's taken the lead.
Shedden has had a moment.
Shedden in trouble again.
Into the wall goes Shedden.
There is the man of the moment. Jason Plato takes his second win of the season.
Oh!
Is Jackson going to go for it?
That's a phenomenal drive by the young man.
Matt Jackson has come from 18th. He's in the second place.
Matt Neal smells victory.
Great second from Matt Neal.
I love being on the podium.
Giovanardi, he'll take another victory.
That was absolutely stunning.
Oh, no, Giovanardi!
Yet another victory this year.
It's a 23-point cushion for Giovanardi over his teammate Matt Neal. Independent BMW driver Matt Jackson's a further 20 points behind in third place. Jason Plato is fourth, a massive 46 points behind the leader Giovanardi. But it's been a perfect start here at Snetterton for Jason Plato. The Seat's locking out the front of the grid. We'll have the highlights of round 16 in a few moments' time after we've heard from Plato and Darren Turner.
This is your trump card, isn't it? This is where you've got to make it all happen, because if it doesn't work here, then it's not going to work anywhere, is it?
Absolutely. You know, this is it. This is where the championship either starts or ends for us. You know, we've generally got an opportunity to win two races, and also I think our race base is strong enough that even with weight and in the pack, we might even get a podium. So, you know, I have to say Fabrizio has done a fantastic job to get fourth there with that weight on. I did notice he came in with his splitter dragging on the ground and missed the weight scales, which normally would have thrown him out. So, knowing VXR as I do, they've probably pulled a stroke or two to get him there, because before that, he was nowhere. So yeah, it is crunch time. If we don't perform this weekend, it's all over.
The team's obviously worked really hard in the break that we've had from the last race at Croft. We've certainly made some improvements, that's for sure. And you know, it works here, and everyone's obviously really confident that, you know, that's going to work everywhere. But obviously, you know, from driving the car at different circuits during the year, I've seen that, you know, it doesn't always transpire that one change will work everywhere. So I'm just sort of holding a bit back. I want to get really excited and say, yeah, we're sorted for the rest of the season and everything's going to be great. But it's going to be great this weekend, and then we just need to make sure that we can make it work at every circuit from here on.
I qualified third here, I think, last year, and I've gone almost a full second faster than I did last year, and I'm still third in the grid. But you know, this year, you know, it shows you how much the pace has moved on. I think the, you know, the turbo cars have obviously got a bit of an advantage round here. But you know, everyone at Team Halfer's done a great job, and the car's good. You know, we almost maximised our performance, which is you know, obviously what you want to do. And you know, we're in the hunt, which is what it's all about.
Well, we had the good results with our car with the Vauxhall last year, and we expect to be in the front, and I restart in the front. So the set is very fast, but we will see with the ballast when the ballast will come reversed.
So here's the grid. Jason Plato and Darren Turner make it an all SEAT front row to the grid, with Gordon Shedden on row two and series leader Fabrizio Giovanardi starting fourth. Tom Chilton is on the third row of the grid with Tom Onslow-Cole, who won here last year. Then it's Colin Turkington in the Team RAC BMW and Stephen Kane in the motor-based version. Adam Jones lines up on the fifth row of the grid with Stephen Jelly. Then it's Matt Neal. He's back on row six with Mike Jordan. Matt Jackson is also further down than expected on row seven with Andrew Jordan. Rob Collard on row eight with John George. Harry Volkard on the ninth row of the grid with Jason Hughes in the MG. Then it's Michael Doyle and Martin Bell. And the rear of the grid sees Aircut and Alan Taylor. Problems then for Alan Taylor. He's not going to make the start of this first race of the day here at Snetterton. He wanders off into the field somewhere, and he's going to have to just watch this first race. It's the two SEATs on the front row of the grid. It's the Team Halfords car of Gordon Shedden is going to try and take the battle to them as we're ready for the lights. Here we are, red lights are on, away we go, and it's Plato and Turner both off the grid. Well, but Giovanardi takes a terrible start. Fabrizio Giovanardi loses 2, 3, maybe 4 places on the run-up to the first corner. It's Plato leading, it's Turner in second place, Shedden in third, Chilton in fourth, Turkington in fifth. It looks like a clean start, but Giovanardi's the big loser.
Giovanardi did a fantastic job in qualifying to put the heaviest car out there on fourth on the grid, but wasted it all with a bad start, too much wheel spin.
He's ahead of his teammate Matt Neal, who's in the middle of a gaggle of BMWs, including Matt Jackson. But it's the diesel-powered SEATs, which were so strong in qualifying, dominant in testing a few weeks ago as well. And it's Plato ahead of teammate Darren Turner, Gordon Shedden in third place, ahead of his teammate Tom Chilton. A bit of locking going up behind Turkington, ahead of Tom Onslow-Cole. Then Stephen Kane is in there, everybody bouncing their way over the curbs. And still, looks as though everybody's made it round safely so far.
Yeah, so far this weekend, it's all been fairly steady, hasn't it? The predictable pace of the SEAT Leon for turbo diesels over half a second quicker than anybody else in practice, but I don't expect it to stay that way over the rest of the weekend as they get weight added after this first race.
Well, they need a good result this weekend. A little bit of something going flying in the air there. Seat had a miserable time last time at Croft, only scoring 5 points out of the three races. So Plato's dropped to fourth in the championship, and he desperately needs some results. Cross the line there, Plato, Turner, Chilton and Shedden together. It's actually Chilton ahead of Shedden that way round. So my mistake there, Tom Chilton had got ahead of his teammate off the start. Good start that for Chilton then. Shedden in fourth, Turkington in fifth. Little battle going on here though, as Tom Onslow-Cole tries to get past Turkington. That is for fifth place. Ooh, on the grass, Onslow-Cole. And the two of them still rubbing bumpers as they head down the Revit straight.
Well, that sort of racing only happens in touring cars, doesn't it? Onslow-Cole was clearly on the outside, and Turkington just kept the car out there, so he put the wheels on the dirt and lost the traction.
Well, good stuff. The SEATs are in control here. Chilton and Shedden, but then it's this battle. Turkington versus Onslow-Cole, and Stephen Kane is a part of that as well. Colin Turkington was on pole position here last year, got disqualified from the race win for being underweight. So we know that car can go extremely well here at Snetterton, but now he's got his work cut out to keep Onslow-Cole. We've got the safety car out. Safety car on track. Now, I'm not quite sure why that is. There may be some debris out there. But it's off as Michael Doyle is off the
track. Another wheel problem. Look at his right front wheel there. Looks like the steering arm's broken or the top ball joint or something. But he's off. He must be in a dangerous place. Otherwise, I don't think they'd have scrambled the safety car this early. Well, that's on the exit of... Oh, John George involved as well. That's on the exit of Riches between the first and second corner, Riches and Sear. Oh, Bell went into the barriers at the Marshall's post trying to avoid John George. That's the serious accident there.
This is on board Jordan. So let's just see. Oh, he got caught out behind. He was sort of trying to brake too late, off in the field.
Corn on the cob for dinner.
Absolutely right. Listen to the quiet diesel. Hardly hear it, can you? I know he's not accelerating hard, but you watch as he comes out of this Russell corner. We'll just go quiet for a second and the diesel will do its stuff.
It's so peaceful.
It's eerie, isn't it? I mean, the good thing these guys know is they know they've got the straight line speed, so they can back the other cars up and just accelerate away from them. And especially as the two quickest parts of the course, the first two straights, are in the first half of the lap.
Again, you can see how did they pull away from Tom Chilton so easily there on the sheer power and acceleration of that diesel turbo. Chilton closes up a little bit through the corners, but Plato, good restart. Chilton trying to hold on. Then we've still got that battle between Turkington and the Team RAC BMW, and Onslow-Cole in the VXR Racing Vectra. Some battles going on further back, but it's really behind the top two yellow and green Sayats that you need to watch for the battles going on. Chilton versus his teammate Shedden, and Shedden just following dutifully at the moment. Then Turkington, then Onslow-Cole. The white BMW is Stephen Kane, going well at the moment. He's followed by Fabrizio Giovanardi, who's had a bit of a second chance here, having lost so many places at the start of the race. Then it's Adam Jones and Rob Collard, who's also come up well from his qualifying position. No changes, though, on the restart so far. Kane in the background was a bit wide out of Russell. He could be under threat from Giovanardi. Just watch behind. Yes, look, Giovanardi's got a little chance at an overlap, trying to get past seventh place man Stephen Kane. There we are, getting alongside on the run up towards Riches, but oh, he's going to try and go around the outside. Fantastic aggressive racing as ever from Giovanardi.
Well, that's incredible, isn't it? How tough was that to turn in from the dirty side of the track and cut across the front? Good driving by Stephen Kane not to touch him as well, but again, a very aggressive pass by Giovanardi.
That was great stuff, I tell you what. They're on the brakes so briefly there, Tim, aren't they? I mean,
yes.
How did he get that run going?
Yeah, it's basically a dab on the brakes and down one gear. So very quick corner, approximate corner speed at the apex, 120 miles an hour.
Adam Jones in the silver, red and black Sayat is on a bit of a run here as well. He's trying to move up if possible, get past Collard. I think Collard actually got past him on that lap. Yes, he did. So Collard is the one that's gained the place. Rob Collard up to ninth. Jones wants it back. Now remember, these two had a coming together last time out at Croft. Adam Jones ended up with a couple of penalty points on his license as a result, but didn't actually have his position change. He's having a look down the inside. Don't hit each other, guys. Oh, the history between them. They have hit each other again. Collard has been displaced, and Adam Jones and Rob Collard, the duel continues.
Well, we've seen this all the time from Adam Jones, and whenever he's passed, he always fights back immediately at the next, or if not the next, the next but one corner. And we saw the same thing again then, but now he's under big pressure. He could hold this if Matt Neal starts putting Collard on pressure, but they're both up the inside now.
Matt Neal's joining in the fun and games in the Vauxhall, the red and white Vauxhall. He's got up the inside there, I think. Yes, he has. Jones is squeezed out wide. Collard gets his place back, and Jones loses one, two, three, four places, maybe five, because Stephen Jelly's alongside him. You make one little mistake in touring cars, and that's what happens. You can lose five places in one go. He's trying to come back, and remember, Adam Jones leads in the independent points category. Meanwhile, Mike Jordan's managed to sneak round past Matt Neal. How'd he do that?
Yeah, and Stephen Jelly's just got past Jones as well by braving it around the outside. Card in the one Chevrolet out there. There he is going through the picture now. The Robert Shaw racing car, the only one out there, and he's back onto the tail.
Yeah, yes. Now, this was what happened a little while ago. Jones tried to get down the inside of Collard. That was the contact that we did see, but it all went wrong for him after that, didn't it?
Well, fortunately, they both straight-lined the chicane. Jones fighting back to regain the place. They make contact, both go the wrong side of the high cue banner and rejoin, but that could have been a lot worse. But they gained the position, but it didn't do him any good because at the next corner, he lost three.
Matt Jackson, oh, he's hit Matt Neal, just a touch there between Jackson and Neal as Jackson tries to take the place. Matt Neal says, if you're going to hit me, I'm going to hit you back. And Jackson ends up on the grass, as he did here last year when he was battling for second, and now they're all trying to swamp him. Jones gets down the inside. Jenny's going to try and go through. What do you make of all that, Tim?
Well, you probably could have predicted, but it's not over yet. They're into corner, the fastest corner. Volcano Jones made contact, front-wheel drive. Jones saves it. Volcano backs off as well. That could have been very tricky. Jackson's already had one accident there this weekend. But, well, you don't touch Matt Neal and get past without expecting some kind of retaliation. And, well, Matt just touched him enough going into the S's to put him on the dirt and then no traction.
Well, hard run. Talk us through it again.
Yeah, coming down the straight, I don't think that it was deliberate. They're just converging. Well, Matt Jackson is trying to move back across onto the line. Matt had a little bit of space on the right, but didn't want to concede anything. So Matt just rolls it into the corner, little touch. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I can imagine that one will get looked at afterwards. This was Matt Neal after the run. He says, oh, I'm just going to try and get in there before you do. and well, we'll see whether he gets into trouble for that or not. With the little tap beforehand, maybe they'll just say, well, it's a little bit 50-50. We're on the final lap, though, for Jason Plato, and it does look as though it's going to be a relatively comfortable victory for Jason. It's about time. They've had a bit of a poor patch, certainly last time out at Croft, but it looks like he's going to come back from that. This will be his third win of the season if he holds on to it. Giovanardi, the championship leader's had four wins so far this year, but interestingly, it'll also be Seat's first 1-2 of the season, so definitely what they need to get back on track.
Yeah, so often this year they've had quick cars but shot themselves in the foot in some respect, and Croft was a great example of that, but it's all worked out fine and they will want to get to bag as many points as possible. But don't forget, Jason Plato will be starting this next race with maximum ballast, so could be a bit tougher for him. But full marks to him, full marks to Seat, full marks to Dunlop. The tyres have worked perfectly round here.
Here we go then, Jason Plato coming through out of that final corner. He's going to take victory in the first race of the day at Snetterton. It's his fourth win in 4 years here at the Norfolk Circuit, his 41st career win, and it's a 1-2 for Seat. Absolutely dominant, with Tom Chilton taking third, Shedden in fourth, and we're waiting for the others to come through. Turkington fifth, Onslow-Cole in sixth place. Good battle for the final points. 10th place just goes to Matt Neal. But it's Plato who takes the victory by half a second from his teammate, Darren Turner. Chilton in third place ahead of Gordon Shedden, his own teammate as well. And then Turkington in fifth. Tom Onslow-Cole in sixth place ahead of his VX Racing teammate, Giovanardi. Then Stephen Kane, another teammate right behind, Rob Collard. And tenth, just on the line, was Matt Neal.
So the first Seat 1-2 of the season and much needed points for Jason Plato's championship campaign. We'll have all the reaction and round 17 after the break. Well, Snetterton's been kind to the Seat so far. Jason Plato and Darren Turner coming through to a very straightforward 1-2 in the first race of the day here. Janie's with them down in the pits.
The guys have made a good step forward with the car. We're still not there with it, but you know, we're getting closer.
I mean, they were close all the way to the end. I mean, the gap between me and Jason across the line was probably the same as the gap I had to Tom. So, you know, it's a very close race, and I think it took us a bit by surprise. So, you know, the next race we just need to work a little bit on this car now and see if we can find a bit more pace. But obviously when I'm following Jason, I can see what his car's doing. And we're just saying then when we got out of the car, we had two cars with pretty much the same setup, but handling completely different. So we're going to sort of play around with the setup now, because he had oversteer, I had understeer, and together we were just going around as a little happy family.
I think the team has done a mega job. We've tweaked the car, we've tweaked my brain. I'm as fit as I've ever been in my life. I want to start doing some triathlons, and yeah, I just feel like I'm on top of my game, and it's all, everything I'm focusing towards is all going in the right direction. I'm very happy.
Okay, well, they're all happy boys, aren't they? And deservedly so. Right, we're cracking on with the action here from Snetterton. It's time for race two of the day. That's round 17, and we'll go back to the commentary box with Ben and Tim.
So here's the grid for the second race of the day. And once again, it's an all Seat front row with Jason Plato and Darren Turner. Team Halfords have the second row with Tom Chilton and Gordon Shedden. Then we've got the first of the BMWs. That's Colin Turkington. Tom Onslow-Cole, former race winner here in sixth. Then seventh is Giovanardi. Stephen Kane is eighth. Rob Collard, ninth on the grid, ahead of Matt Neal. Still struggling a little bit in his Vauxhall. Mike Jordan is 11th. Stephen Jelly is in 12th position. Then it's Adam Jones, Harry Volkard, Matt Jackson starting 15th. Jason Hughes in 16th. Then it's John George and Eckert. He lines up in 18th place. And then behind them, we've got Andrew Jordan and Michael Doyle. Martin Bell should line up 21st. He's a bit sore after that accident earlier. And Alan Taylor should line up in 22nd. Wait for those lights to come out, and then a short pause, and they'll be away. Lights out, away we go. Very quick this time, and again the two Seats are pretty fast off the line. Chilton and Shedden go with them. So does Colin Turkington. Don't think Turkington's been able to make full advantage of his rear-wheel drive, but he's close up behind the leaders. Turner trying to go around the outside of Plato. The two Seats side by side through Riches, but can Plato hold on the inside? I think he will. So it's still Jason Plato leading. Darren Turner trying to slot into second, but he's been pushed out of the way. I think Chilton, oh, and off goes John George. Oh, he's been off a few times today, and he's off again in this one. I think Chilton might have taken second, Tim. We'll have to see what's going on.
We're on board Turkington now, and you can see Chilton and Shedden in front. And it looks as though the Seat Turner has held on to second place. The power of that Seat down the straight has just saved him.
Yeah, it got him back in front. It's still attacking though. Chilton almost got up the inside there. Great view from on the front bumper here of the BMW of Colin Turkington. The Team RAC. Oh, a mistake from Turner and a mistake there from Shedden as well. Cold tyres, that's the problem.
Yeah, we're seeing a little bit of cold tyre front wheel drive problems on the first lap. And here we are through a faster corner. But Turkington couldn't capitalise on that.
Chilton's up into second place, so Darren Turner has dropped to third, and we've got a change. It's not a Seat 1-2. Turkington we're riding with, still trying to get past Gordon Shedden as well. But up front, it's Jason Plato that leads. Tom Chilton in an excellent second place. Superb first lap there from Chilton. Darren Turner has been pushed back to third. Shedden in fourth, Turkington in fifth, and Giovanardi is putting all the pressure on Colin Turkington there. The reigning champion and series leader right up there at the moment as they head up towards here. Here comes Giovanardi. Yeah, he's got down the inside of Turkington. Classic manoeuvre there, and he's through. He's gained one, he's into fifth place.
Yeah, Giovanardi, much more what we expected to see of him. He got a great start, unlike the first race. It was Onslow-Cole this time in the Vauxhall team that slipped back. I saw Giovanardi dive up the inside into the first corner, and he's carried on that progress.
Yeah, he has moved up, but watch the battle up front as well, because Darren Turner was trying to get his second place back, and I think he might have done it. I think Darren Turner's used his diesel power. Yeah, look, he managed to just drive past Tom Chilton. Slides again. Chilton is back to third, and that's the power advantage that Seat have here.
Yeah, we didn't see it, but clearly he was able to drive past. It is the longest straight in British motorsport. We've said that before. The Halfords cars side by side.
Shedden down the inside, and he's taken the place from Tom Chilton. But watch out, boys. You've got Giovanardi breathing down your... No, and off goes Jelly. Yeah, Stephen Jelly. Looked like there was a bit of assistance there somewhere.
Definitely a tap on the back. The front-wheel drive cars can save those kind of slides. The rear-wheel drive cars can't.
Giovanardi then having a little look to get up the inside of Chilton. Not close enough.
Oh, he's touched him.
Just a little rub, Giovanardi. Oh, and he's over the curb, bouncing around. He's under pressure now from Turkington once again. Turkington's got the inside line. They're being ganged up on other BMWs around the outside. Stephen Kane, Rob Collard as well. And Giovanardi could lose out big time here unless he finds the right slot to get back into.
Yeah, Giovanardi getting a dose of his own medicine from Turkington there. Lost speed through Riches, looking for a way past the Honda. And now look at them, four abreast.
2, 4, 6 cars all battling for the same place. Turkington's got it. Giovanardi's trying to squeeze with one of the Team Alphans cars and Tom Chilton. But through, oh, he's got knocked sideways by Chilton. Giovanardi tries to hold it. He can't. He can't. And eventually he's on the grass.
Yeah, he still managed to keep going in the right direction, but that was never going to work, was it? Five cars going into that corner. Giovanardi will be livid because he's clearly got good pace, but he just couldn't hold on to it.
Well, that could be interesting to watch his recovery now. So Turkington has taken... Oh, and Chilton on the grass. Tom Onslow-Cole...
Has he got a puncture? He may have a puncture or a problem.
Good. Oh, and Onslow-Cole almost spins. Colton just about. Great recovery from him. It's going crazy back there. Rob Collard is in the lead of the motor-based BMWs.
Chilton into the pit lane. I think he has got a puncture.
Right, well spotted. And Mike Jordan there now has got to the front of that next. Oh, contact on the straight. Come on, boys. Behave yourselves. Getting a bit silly out there. Tom Chilton, it was all pretty clean in the first race. They're all letting loose now. As you can see, Tom Onslow-Cole's in there, so's Adam Joe. How Volkard this time. Spins, half spins, regathers control. Andrew Jordan was the one who made contact, and they both lose places. Michael Doyle goes up the inside, and it's another front bumper gone from Andy Jordan. He lost it in the first race. He's going to lose it in this one as well. Oh, it's all
and
a bit crazy.
He may have been dropping fluid there as well. He may have been dropping some radiator fluid there, so that could be dangerous next time round.
Yeah, definitely a lot of smoke, whether it's steam or tyre smoke. It's a little hard to tell at the moment, but Andy Jordan in trouble. I should think he may well be coming in the pits. His dad under pressure here from Tom Onslow-Cole. Onslow-Cole up on the outside in the Vauxhall, and Mike Jordan's going to have to defend here on the inside. And also, oh, look at them making contact. Onslow-Cole trying to get around the outside. Adam Jones, you can't go three abreast, surely. They do. That's remarkable. Now Jones has got the inside into Seat. Still Jordan and Onslow-Cole making contact. Onslow-Cole squeezed out wide, and Giovanardi's going to take advantage.
He might pick up three places here, Giovanardi. This is a really topsy-turvy touring car race.
This is brilliant. He might have been a bit quiet in the first one, but they're really letting fly now. The Vauxhall on the left, you can see there, is Giovanardi, who's managed to get to the front of this little group once again. Oh, he's just locked up a little into the S's, gets the control back into the second part, and he's ahead of Adam Jones. Volkard, he got sideways one way, and then Andy Jordan couldn't really help but sort of tap him the other way, but the others piled fast. There are the two leaders, though, and Jason and Darren Turner well out in front of Gordon Shedden under no pressure whatsoever. All round goes Matt Neal. Was there contact on the Exeter Riches? Matt Neal regathers momentum. Amazing save. He gets going again. What a fast corner to spin at.
Yeah, and he's dropped back behind Giovanardi. I couldn't see from that angle where there was contact. Collard is, I think there possibly was a touch there. It's unusual to run into the car that far around the corner, but...
Here we go. This should be a good view for us, Tim.
Kay was looking to carry the momentum up the entire into Sear and just caught the back of Neil's car.
Oh, look at this, the leader swapping around. Now, you gain an extra point for leading. Sayat have done this before where they allow one of them to... Yeah, Turner's just led that lap according to our timing screens. You get an extra point for that. And I think that's what they're doing here.
Yes, they've got such a luxury, they can actually afford to just let Turner lead across the line and get the extra point. And certainly the pace that they're carrying in this race with the full ballast means that they really have got a very fast car here this weekend.
Giovanardi tight into the curb at Coram. Down towards Russell they come. Safety car is on track. Now, I don't know what that's for, but something has happened somewhere, and the safety car on circuit. So...
not what Sayat wanted to see, but on the other hand, we've seen from the restart after the safety car in the first race that they can easily outdrag everybody, but it will close up some of the other gaps.
The other thing, of course, is it does take the pressure off their tyres a bit, doesn't it? Because it gives them a chance to cool their tyres down. The Sayat is slightly nose heavy, as we know. Maybe actually, in some ways, it's quite good for them. Ah, it was a barrier. It was a barrier that got moved partly onto the track. That was the reason for the safety car. Plato making sure he's got plenty of ease in the tyres. Here we go then, safety car comes into the pits. And the Sayats are on the power immediately. Plato makes a good restart. I don't know if Darren's got a bit of a problem.
He's got a problem with his gear shift. He can't change gear.
Here comes Gordon Shedden attacking for second. There's an opportunity to get
out. He's got puncture, left front.
Puncture on the Sayat. Disaster for Sayat when they were looking all set for another 1-2. And it's a puncture on the left front for Darren Turner. It wasn't just a gear shift problem. Much more serious than that. Plato's on his own up front now, and that promotes the others. So, Shedden moves up into second place. Turkington's up to third as Darren Turner desperately just tries to get himself back to the pits. He's not going to get any kind of result out of this. Plato on his own up front now. Shedden into second place and under pressure from Colin Turkington. Look at Giovanardi having a little look to get past Rob Collard. Not quite close enough just yet.
This is just what Giovanardi wanted, didn't he, after that difficult start. The pack to be closed up again, a few more laps of racing. He's got a fast car, very aggressive, just what he needed to keep the championship points rolling in.
But Collard is notoriously feisty himself and a hard man to pass. Collard and Giovanardi have come together before. Now Giovanardi's going to go for it down the inside. He's trying to take the playoff, yes. So good on the brakes. I mean, he braked so late and yet the car was stable.
Yeah, very committed, totally committed to the manoeuvre. Collard didn't even put up a fight. I think it was so straightforward that if he tried to move over, he'd have been hit up the back.
Oh, out of Darren Turner, he's out, but look at this. This is great. This is for second now. You're on board third place Turkington, right behind Gordon Shedden. Remember, Giovanardi's behind both of them, trying to take advantage. Oh, mistake from Shedden. Turkington's through, Shedden's on the grass. He's trying to hold it, and Giovanardi's gone past as well, and so has Rob Collard. Turkington is into second place, Giovanardi into third position, and we've still got, what is it, three laps to go as they cross the line this time. Jason Plato will in front, but you know what? Giovanardi might still take second.
Yeah, well, there's just the faintest hint of a black mark on the left front splitter there of Turkington, so there may have been a bit of contact with Shedden going into Coram, but Giovanardi isn't finished.
No, certainly not. We had some more people on the ground. Look how much curb he uses at Sear. Really is aggressive on the curb. It's a strong engine in the BMW. And it just stays ahead through there. Again, Giovanardi tries to get the exit better this time. This is where he lost a bit,
yeah,
wasn't it?
Yeah, just watch through here. This time, Giovanardi's a little bit better. But he will certainly think that into Russell is his best chance. He needs to be fully committed through here. But he just can't be close enough to Turkington to launch an attack.
No, and he got to protect the car. Matt Neal down the inside behind them. Matt Neal's managed to get past Stephen Kane. And that was a good move. And in fact, Stephen Kane may lose out to Gordon Shenton here as well. He's got Matt Jackson bearing down on him. And that's the trouble. If one car gets through, quite often it's two, three, four cars. And Stephen Kane now has Gordon Shenton moving to his outside. Turkington, Giovanardi, then Collard, then Matt Neal. Now ahead of Stephen Kane, who just about fights off Shenton, who actually lost out to Jackson.
Yeah, Jackson just stuck his nose up behind Kane and followed him through, NASCAR style, a bit of drafting.
Yeah, good stuff. It is all about strategy and tactics and just being in the right place at the right time when it gets this close. We're on the final lap, though, here. Jason Plato has a 3.5-second lead, but it's behind him that all the fun and games is going on. Plato surely heading for another victory, but here comes Giovanardi having a look at second. Not quite there. Turkington defending resolutely. No contact made through the left and the right. Now just the two quick corners and the final chicane at Russell. Turkington should be able to hold on here. Jason Plato out in front. He's not troubled at all, but he will be a little troubled to have seen Giovanardi move back up the order quite so effectively in this race. It is amazing how Giovanardi can dig himself out of trouble, and that's what he's done here in the second race of the day. It's going to be victory once again for the second time today for SEAT, for Jason Plato. Four wins this season, but second place goes to Turkington and third goes to Giovanardi. Collard comes home in fourth. Matt Neal is fifth. I think Gordon Shenton, no, he drops back in the bit there, so then it's Stephen Kane in sixth, Matt Jackson in seventh, and Gordon Shenton is in eighth. Jason, it might be a comfortable winner, but behind him, those guys knew they were in a race, with Turkington in particular doing well to hold on to second place and winning the independents category. Giovanardi third, Collard in fourth place, Matt Neal in fifth, then Stephen Kane, then Matt Jackson, Gordon Shenton, Mike Jordan finished in ninth, Adam Jones in 10th place, and then just outside the point, Stephen Jelly and Jason Hughes. Michael Doyle, good effort from him in the Intune Racing car, ahead of Tom Onslow-Cole, then Tom Chilton, John George, Harry Volkard, Martin Bell, Darren Turner, who lived to the end, and Alan Taylor, who finished 20th.
Well done, lads.
Well done.
So Jason Plato secures that really important second win of the day here at Snetterton, and we'll hear from him and the very fortunate Fabrizio Giovanardi in a couple of minutes' time.
DC.
So professional racing drivers turned absolute hooligans in round 17 here at Snetterton. The Vauxhall Vectra acting as a pinball between BMWs and Hondas. Let's hear from the drivers down in the pits with Janie.
I heard GOP14 during the race. I thought, oh, that's perfect. That's exactly what we need. We're back on track. And then the stinkers on the podium. I mean, I don't know what it is now, what, 20-something points? I mean, that's great. You know, we came here 46, I think it was. We're now down 28. It could have been even better had there not been some shenanigans back there. But, you know, we're back in the hunt. The way things are going at the moment, it's not ridiculous to even contemplate trying to win.
I'm delighted to come through from fifth to second. You know, the safety car helped me out a little bit, but, you know, that's three independent wins today for Team RSC, so it's really good.
I really enjoyed this race, not completely, because in the end, when someone spin, I don't want to say who, someone spin me, I was so angry, so angry. That gave me power, and is what I did is for that.
It's just really devastating because it's you know, we had a good race. The start was okay, then I got tangled up with a few of the Hondas on the first lap or so, but made the break and then closed in with Jason, and then we were sort of keeping it to the sort of 1-2 to the end of the race. And obviously the safety car came out, and it's the same for everyone. You know, we're going to have to do a restart. I thought that's something strange because that vibration's just come from nowhere, and then it was a punch or so. You know, that was the end of the race, and it just means now we're going to have to really work hard to get any points in the third race.
So in the draw for race three of the day here at Snetterton, Gordon Shenton was selected as being on pole position in the Honda Civic. Jason Plato will start eighth on the grid as he attempts to do what he's never done before and win three races out of three. Can he do it? Let's rejoin Ben and Tim.
So here's the grid for the final race of the day. Gordon Shenton on pole for Team Halfords. Alongside him is Matt Jackson. Then it's Stephen Kane and Matt Neal on the second row. Rob Collard in the second motorbase car starts fifth. Giovanardi starts from sixth position, seventh on the grid. Colin Turkington, Jason Plato, double winner today, starts eighth. Mike Jordan should start there, but he's starting from pit lane. Adam Jones, 10th. Stephen Jelly, 11th. Then Jason Hughes starts 12th. 13th, Michael Doyle ahead of Tom Onslow-Cole, Tom Chilton and John George. Harry Volkard is 17th. Martin Bell starts 18th. And then towards the back, Darren Turner, no ballast on board. See where he can get to. Alan Taylor's alongside. Then it's Ericut and Andrew Jordan who complete the grid. Right, engine revs begin to rise. We're set to go racing for the third and final time
Away we go at Shedden, and Matt Jackson gets a great rocket start. So does Stephen Kane, and it's the rear-wheel drive BMWs. Look at that, 1-2, Matt Jackson under pressure from Stephen Kane as they head up towards Richards Corner. Stephen Kane trying to squeeze through for the lead, but no, it's Matt Jackson who takes the advantage, and the pole man, Gordon Shedden, back to third. Here comes Kane. Oh, I thought he was going to move down the inside there. Good start from Rob Collard as well. And the rest of them now fighting their places.
Jason Plato had an absolute mare of a start. He dropped back many places. In actual fact, Darren Turner, that's Jason Plato pulling out to use the Seat power to pass a few cars. But he really lost out a lot. And Giovanardi has swept through.
Shedden having a little look down the inside of Stephen Kane's car into the S's, but no way through just yet. Poor start, you would say, for Shedden, but not really. It's just that the rear-wheel drive BMWs always have the advantage at the start. So Shedden did his best, but the rear-wheel drive cars around him and behind him got through. There's Darren Turner gaining one place on this opening lap. So perhaps a prediction of Dave Ward, team boss, that Darren Turner would maybe catch and pass Plato isn't too far beyond the point here. Race leaders come down into the first, into Russell, the final chicane. Giovanardi tucked in there behind Matt Neal, his teammate, I think, in the battle of the Vauxhalls, and both of them are now ganging up on Rob Collard. Here comes Matt Neal to the outside.
Well, we've seen the Vauxhalls go around the outside. I don't think Neal is quite close enough. He's going to have to brave it out, but Collard's a tough nut to pass, and I thought Giovanardi might look up the inside. Neal sweeping back inside, Collard's run wide, the door's open, and watch Giovanardi up behind Neal as well. Neal's cleanly through, will Giovanardi get in?
Well, he certainly got into the sear corner ahead of Collard as Matt Neal, and as you say, Giovanardi's got a chance to draw alongside the BMW, side by side down the Revit straight, 130, 135, nearly 140 miles an hour before they get on the brakes, and you're on board with Colin Turkington. Look at how close he is to the back of Giovanardi, down towards the S's then. Who's going to win the battle on the brakes here? Into the left-hander, squeeze into the right-hander, brakes locking, and they've both got past Collard.
Yeah, they set up a line of cars on the outside and just swept round. There was no way back in for Collard. Fortunately, no contact.
Jones coming through. We've just heard on the radio that Darren Turner's got an engine problem, I think. Just heard something from Darren Turner with our onboard radio that he may have an engine problem. Now, Darren Turner has dropped back here, Tim, and I think he has got a problem, as we thought. He's dropped several places.
Yeah, he's asking the team if they want him to carry on or blow the engine up, but they want him to carry on if they possibly can and to score some points.
Back to that battle for second, and here comes Gordon Shedden. Where is he going? He's going off to Thetford. No, he's back on the track. The old track used to head down that way to the A11, but he's back on the circuit. But the battle for second place that he was wanting, well, it's all over for the moment.
That was really driver error, because he looks as though he's going to go down the outside, but then realises there's not enough room, gets a wheel on the grass and just can't stop the car.
Oh, that's a great... And Giovanardi's passed Neal. That's for fourth. Oh, this is a good threat now from Fabrizio Giovanardi. He's got past his teammate, and now he's got to go chasing after. It will be Stephen Kane. In fact, he'll be third now, because we've lost Shedden from those lead positions. That's third place for Giovanardi. He's got the BMW of Stephen Kane to try and catch. And Stephen Kane in the best ever position at the moment for Motorbase. So he'll want to hold on to second place, but he's got the championship leader behind him. Away they go up the straight one more time. And Plato there, I think Plato might have a problem as well, you know. Look, he's just lost,
yeah.
He's just lost some places.
I was watching that, very unusual to see the Seat get that kind of problem on the straight. We'll have to see. I think JP's got the same problem as Darren Turner.
In the pits has come Shedden after that slide on the grass. Did he pick up a puncture or something else? I don't know. They're having a good look around. This is Motorbase's best sort of run of the season so far. Here comes Onslow-Cole down the inside of Stephen Jelly. And Stephen Jelly sort of saw him coming and left the door open once he was committed. And Onslow-Cole into seventh place, but Jelly might try and come back at him. Onslow-Cole is always fast here at Snetterton, so don't count him out of the picture in terms of moving up the order a little bit. He's got to try and get past Collard and Turkington as well. And Jelly trying to have a little go back at him here. And in fact, he might get it. He's alongside. He's got the inside line, but no, he runs a bit wide on the exit, and Onslow-Cole gets it back.
Well, he did the hard part. Jelly did the hard part, which is to break round the outside. Then he just couldn't get the car stopped for the right-hander. Now he's lost three places back.
Yeah, that was silly, really, because he could have held that place, or at least only lost one, but now he's lost three. He's still learning, though. He's out of single seaters. He's not used to quite this rough and tumble of touring car racing, and every step like that is another lesson, and Stephen will be kicking himself afterwards, but he'll learn from it. He'll come back and fight again another time.
Oh, smoke coming out of that that Seat was all going so well for them this weekend.
Oh, look, that's Onslow-Cole up the inside of Collard. Onslow-Cole gains another one. That's sixth place now for Tom Onslow-Cole. So he's gradually working his way nearer the front. And Vauxhall's suddenly coming alive in this race. They're running in third, in fourth place, and now into sixth position as well. There's some glum faces at Seat.
Scott Dennis, motorsport manager at Seat, and obviously looking very disappointed. Every time they try and get it right for the whole weekend, something seems to conspire to hinder them, and it makes championships very hard to win.
Yeah, desperately frustrating for them. Collard versus Chilton and Adam Jones. This is for seventh. There's Plato in now. So Jason Plato, after all the successes of earlier on today, two victories, but there's no way it's going to be three wins this afternoon. And now Tom Onslow-Cole is putting Colin Turkington under pressure. Onslow-Cole's been doing more overtaking than virtually anyone in this race so far. In the second of these two, the red and white cars. But we hear that Plato is going to be coming back out onto the circuit. So Jason Plato will try and rejoin this race, but, well, he's not really going to score anything, I think. On board Turkington, under pressure now from Tom Onslow-Cole. These two guys were teammates last year, and now they're racing. And there's Plato just rejoining from the pit lane, as you saw from that shot.
Yeah, look at that great on board there of Onslow-Cole. His car looking fantastic. He's looking down the inside. This is his favourite place to pass into Slea, and he gets the job done. And no surprise, he was half a second quicker on the last lap, so really found a sweet spot in his car for this third race.
He was so quick through Richards, wasn't he? I mean, Turkington had nothing he could do there. Unusual in a way to see someone just go straight up the inside into Sear, but it was because of his speed through the previous corner. Look behind, there's some fun and games going on. Adam Jones trying to come down the inside. Tom Chilton going around the outside. Oh, good stuff from Chilton. Managed to hold on there. Collard stays in front of Adam Jones, and they all just about get through the corner. Now Jones is going to try and get up the inside. Into Bumhole. Oh, these two again making a little bit of contact, as they did at Croft last timeout, as they did earlier on today when they came into Russell, and Jones gets through.
Oh, great side-by-side racing there. Collard got put out on the marbles, and he's going to lose another place now to Jelly, whose opportunist move is getting into this touring car racing.
Yeah, he's learning. Meanwhile, apparently Jason Plato is getting a black flag, so he's forced to retire now. Look, there you are, car number 11. That is Jason Plato. He has to come into the pits and report to the clerk of the course.
I wonder if that's because he's been dropping some fluid. Well, that would have been a mechanical flag if that was it, but clearly they don't think the car should be out there.
So Volcard's in trouble.
Yeah, puncture there on the right front, which is unusual to get a puncture on the right front. You can see here down the straight, the car's deflated and he's struggling to slow the car down. Unusual to get it on the right-hand side. Obviously, the left-hand side is the loaded corner, but the trouble is that if the driver's cut the circuit too much, there's some sharp curbs and some flint.
And here's Turkington versus Tom Chilton. Chilton's got to try and keep it clean. He had a little bit of contact in that race, the second race in particular, so Giovanardi was a bit upset about it, but it all settled down and Giovanardi was able to recover from it. But here's Chilton on a track he knows and loves, and in seventh, wanting that sixth place and trying to get past the BMW.
Listen to the revs as he goes down that gearbox. The car virtually on the rev limiter, using the engine as much as possible to slow it down, but without over-revving it.
Yeah, very important, that part of the circuit. Just to keep it under control, but Turkington using all the curb and a bit of grass there into Coram. And look how close Chilton is. Oh, almost touching at one of the faster sections of the circuit. And Adam Jones is right there with him, looking for a little way past as well.
Yeah, Chilton got a bit too close at the wrong point there. Came up behind him on the apex rather than carrying the momentum to the exit. But they're onto the last lap now. Turkington has got one more lap to hang on to that sixth place if possible.
I think Stephen Kane will only sort of go for it if presented a big opportunity, because he will not want to throw away a second place finish. But Matt Jackson controls it through the bomb hole. They've now got just two corners to go, basically. The fast, sweeping Coram corner. No problems through there. And then down to the final right-left. That's the Russell chicane. And it's Matt Jackson that's heading for victory. Stephen Kane jumps over the curb into that one. Matt Jackson's going to come through to take his second victory of 2008. But it's a first-ever podium finish for the motor-based performance team. Stephen Kane takes second. Giovanardi a fine third for Vauxhall. Fourth place and fifth are going to go to Vauxhall as well, with that Vectra very strong in the final race of the day. Colin Turkington, I think, is just about going to hold on to sixth. Yes, he does, from Chilton, Jones, Stephen Jelly in the points this time, and Rob Collard. But congratulations to Matt Jackson, the fourth win of his career. Matt Jackson takes victory, but a fantastic second place for Stephen Kane.
So the indignity of a black flag brings a sour note to the end of Jason Plato's weekend. But a great win for Matt Jackson, his second of the season, and we'll hear from him in a couple of minutes' time. So the key moment to round 18 here at Snetterton was a great start by Matt Jackson in the BMW, and he managed to hold that lead all the way through to the chequered flag to finish ahead of Stephen Kane in the other BMW 320 and ahead of Fabrizio Giovanardi in the Vauxhall Vectra. Absolutely delighted, and rightly so. Let's have a look at the classification, just a confirmation of that. Matt Jackson from Stephen Kane and Fabrizio Giovanardi. Matt Neal came in fourth. Tom Onslow fifth in the other Vauxhall Vectra ahead of Colin Turkington. Tom Chilton, Adam Jones has had a great weekend. Stephen Jelly and Rob Collard round out the top 10. Just tidying up the Drivers' Championship then, Fabrizio Giovanardi with an increased lead, 34 points now from his own teammate Matt Neal. Jason Plato, despite two wins, slips down to third position. Matt Jackson fourth ahead of Colin Turkington and Tom Onslow-Cole. Right, let's go down to Janie in the pits.
You were oh so close at Croft and now you've done it again. This is what it's all about.
Absolutely, yeah, we've had a tough time. We've been in the barriers at about 110 mile an hour, so you know, for everybody in the team, it's you know, it's great, you know, to start the weekend on such a low, to end it on such a high. It's you know, all the guys in the team have done a fantastic job.
We've just got Stephen Kane just sliding in beside you here. We're going to talk to him in a second. How much pressure was he putting you under?
For sure, yeah, no, he was there. He made very few mistakes. I think I was making a lot more mistakes than what Stephen was, and yeah, you know, he put the pressure on. There was no way we could sort of ease off. At one point, I thought, yeah, we're pulling a nice gap here, and all of a sudden, he found full throttle.
We started off the year very well. A few rounds, we struggled a little bit, but you know, we've worked over the last couple of rounds very hard as a team, and I'm glad to bring it home in second for Dave.
Talk us through the race. How was it for you? We've just heard from Matt Jackson saying the amount of pressure that you were putting him under. What about for you?
The race, you know, was, you know, the car was excellent to start off with. You know, I got off the line, made a good start, had a bit of pressure from Gordon. And after a few laps, I started to get into the rhythm. Then I started to push and I was catching Matt, you know, pretty easily. But obviously, Fabrizio was behind me and I didn't want to lose the second place. So I just sort of conceded and I didn't want to start fighting and going backwards. So I just sat there, and then when I realised that Fabrizio wasn't really, he didn't have the pace at the end of the race, the last couple of laps, so I ended up pushing again and I was quite close to Matt. So I think there could have been a win there, but at the end of the day, a podium at this point in the championship is quite good.
I think in the end, because the set had problem, it was the perfect day because he didn't gain on me a lot of points, but I tried until the end to catch the two BMW, but no way, really no way. They was pretty faster than me. They didn't make any mistakes, so it's okay. In the end of the day, two podium, score points. I think it's perfect. Today was perfect for my car, for my team, everything.
Well, our next touring cars are from Alton Park, and that's on Sunday, the 27th of July. The coverage is once again split around the Tour de France, but we start in our regular time slot, 12:30, here on ITV4. But here at Snetterton, it's been a case of win, win, and then bust for Jason Plato and the Seat. But Fabrizio Giovanardi has provided some fantastic entertainment. Proof, if anyone needed, that the action round here in Norfolk is nowhere near as flat as the scenery. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.